Daniel Morcombe's mother has spent another day listening to depraved testimony that's sadly yet to reveal the truth about his disappearance. Disgusting human beings, she says, have simply lied, in one case out of sick revenge against a former lover.
Daniel Morcombe's family is searching for answers that will help solve their son's suspected murder, but so far have listened to what they say are lies and deception.
Absolutely disgusting humans.
P32 is known to police as a pedophile, although he has never been charged with child sex offences. His lover, P33, told officers they abducted, raped and murdered Daniel Morcombe, dumping his body in the Brisbane River days later. P33 made the confession to detectives after describing scars on Daniel's body, a description of his watch and the location of footprints where the 13-year-old was snatched from 7 years ago. Detective Virginia Gray told the inquest, "We approached it from the perspective to prove him correct, but his admissions don't hold any credibility." Daniel's parents confirmed there were no scars and police divers found no trace of the body.
Well, I think that's just a demonstration to the public in how hard over the 7 years it has been for police to identify truth from fiction.
The inquest heard the alleged confession is a conspiracy theory by P33, who was found guilty of raping a girl after P32 told police.
You know, they're people who are notorious liars and whose, you know, criminal histories are just deplorable.
An eyewitness told the inquest that she heard at least two male voices and a young boy scream near the overpass on the day Daniel disappeared, but took 18 months before she told officers that Daniel was crouched nearby. P33 will give evidence tomorrow and an expected confession that already doesn't hold much weight. Anthony Donaghy, 10 News.